Amazon says it will launch its first two internet satellites in late 2022. Chances are that Elon Musk's Starlink project will be very successful in the future, and as always, Jeff Bezos couldn't stay behind. As the owner of Amazon, he has its own project to launch internet satellites with the goal to provide global broadband access, especially to rural and remote areas. The project is called KUIPER Systems, and it's planning to launch its first two internet satellites into orbit on the fourth quarter of 2022. Now, let's dive deeper into this interesting project and find out if it will be able to compete against Elon Musk's Starlink. Amazon first introduced Project KUIPER in 2018. Their main initiative aims to build a satellite constellation of 3,236 satellites that will beam internet to low-latency broadband internet coverage over the next decade. In July 2020, the FCC approved them to build the satellites. Amazon said that they are investing $10 billion into the project. Amazon claims that the satellites will have the ability to serve about 95% of the world's population and successfully positioned Amazon as a global internet service provider. Last Monday, Amazon applied for an experimental license with the Federal Communications Commission, FCC. The filing states that two satellite prototypes by the name of KuiperSat-1 and KuiperSat-2 will launch aboard an experimental rocket RS-1 designed by ABL Space Systems in the fourth quarter of 2022. The goal of this prototype launch would be to test and validate the satellite's propulsion, power and altitude control systems, thermal design, and over-the-air software update capabilities. KUIPER Systems would also collect data on the launch operations and mission management. While announcing the move, Amazon Vice President Rajiv Badial said in a blog post, the satellites will let the company test the communications and networking technology that will be used in the final satellite design and help them validate launch operations and mission management procedures that will be used when developing the full constellation. The two prototype satellites will operate at about 366 miles, which is approximately 590 kilometers, above Earth, which is one of three orbital altitudes the FCC license for use by KUIPER. Under the same license, Amazon must send up around half of its planned total constellation within the next 6 years. Once in orbit, the satellite would link up with ground stations in South America, Texas, Asia, and four customer terminal units made by Amazon. According to Allied Market Research, the satellite broadband market could generate up to $18.6 billion by the year 2030. This mission will officially place Project KUIPER against space technology powerhouses like SpaceX, Starlink and OneWeb, which are already in the market. These two companies have spent the past few years building their low-orbit constellations. However, unlike Project KUIPER, SpaceX has already launched about 1,722 satellites, while OneWeb has launched about 322 satellites. SpaceX has gone ahead and made a beta program for hundreds of users. But for Project KUIPER, these are the first satellites that they will be launching. Amazon shared in the press release that KuiperSat-1 and KuiperSat-2 will include much of the technology and subsystems that power the production version of our satellite design, such as phased array and parabolic antennas, power and propulsion systems, and custom design modems. Amazon developed four low-cost customer terminals and, using the prototypes, Project KUIPER plans to carry out experimental tests on them, specifically how well they connect to the internet satellites. Amazon Vice President of Technology, Rajiv Badial, gave a statement and said, "We'll soon be ready to see how the satellites perform in space. There is no substitute for on-orbit testing, and we expect to learn a lot given the complexity and risk of operating in such a challenging environment. We can't wait to get started." Amazon claims to have conducted ground testing with its user terminal. They built a 2,019,000 square foot facility in Redmond, Washington, specifically for this purpose to test and manufacture the satellites. There are plans to add another 20,000 square foot facility. Project KUIPER says that the technology gets maximum throughput speeds of up to 400 megabytes per second, compared to Starlink's beta program that offers download speeds of up to 100 megabytes to 200 megabytes per second. This is quite better. Will this speed be maintained once the satellites are launched and in orbit around the Earth? Project KUIPER said that it would perform a propulsive deorbit at the end of the mission. This means that the satellites would burn up in the Earth's atmosphere at the end of their useful life. They also said that should the process fail, the satellites would passively deorbit via orbital decay 3.5 years from launch. KUIPER's choice to fly its first two prototypes on ABL's RS-1 rockets came as a surprise to many. This is considering the fact that in April, the New York Times said that Amazon had already purchased 9 launches for its satellites through United Launch Alliance's workhorse Atlas V rocket. Meanwhile, ABL has yet to launch one of its rockets. The first test launch with the RS-1 is expected to happen before the end of the year, launching from Alaska. According to blog post, KUIPER said that it has been impressed by ABL's unique capabilities, rapid deployment progress, and dedication to customers. The FCC application also included plans for the RS-1 rocket, which is designed by ABL Space Systems. It will be capable of launching roughly 1.5 tons of payload into low orbit for about $12 million per flight. The rocket will launch from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. Badial said in the post, "We have been working closely with the ABL team for several months and already completed 2 integration design reviews, including plans for a novel adapter design. We will conduct an initial fit check early next year." The Amazon blog post noted that more than 750 people are working on the project. Some of the people are said to have come from Amazon's purchase of Meta's satellite internet venture, which closed earlier this year. In addition to this, they expect to hire hundreds more in the next year. Badial also told the paper that they have been talking to their competitor, SpaceX, for assistance. This is expected, considering the fact that Elon Musk's SpaceX has more than 1,700 satellites in orbit currently. This puts SpaceX in the lead of the satellite internet race. In August, an application with the FCC showed that SpaceX already had more than 90,000 users of its Starlink satellites. However, Amazon and SpaceX are at odds with who gets to own space. CNBC reported in February that Jeff Bezos' founded company has filed a petition with the FCC to prohibit SpaceX from modifying parts of its Starlink satellites. Even though Amazon said that it supports the ability of operators to modify their system designs, the company argues that the changes are too complex and should not be approved. This has led to the grounding of future Starlink batches. Viasat, an American communications company, also filed a petition to the FCC to investigate internet satellites. They claim that the constellation poses environmental hazards. The document mentions several grievances, like SpaceX's satellites' failure rate to devices colliding in orbit and re-entry pollution risks. There have been strong concerns raised amongst a wide number of players in the industry this summer about the satellite's orbital debris, space safety, and interference issues, John Janker, Viasat's Chief Officer for Global Government Affairs and Regulatory, told DailyMail.com last year. He went on and added that, "It is not SpaceX. These concerns are about mega constellations in general, anyone proposing to send thousands and tens of thousands of satellites into orbit." What do you think about Project KUIPER's first launch? Do you think that they will be able to face off against Elon Musk's Starlink? What do you think they should do differently? Let us know in the comments section below. Remember to leave a like, subscribe, and hit the bell button to get notifications on our next video. Until next time, bye.